My name's Joseph. Welcome to the Eclectic Philatelist, episode number 3. Today we're going to be talking about some Philatelic reference books. Now, I think that the three books we're going to talk about today are almost an essential part of any stamp collector's library. They're each a little bit different in their focus and their aim. One is more of a geographical and information type book. It's an atlas, actually. Another one is a quite well-known book. It's been out for a long, long time, but it is kind of the basic textbook of all the technical aspects of the hobby. And then finally, we're going to talk about one that is of special interest, especially to a topical stamp collector. So let's start things off right away with one of my favorite books on my bookshelf, The Stamp Atlas. This is the Stamp Atlas. I'll put some other still photos of some of the content up on the video here shortly. Now, I think this is an excellent book to have. There are a couple of different atlases for the stamp collecting hobby that are available, but this one is, I think, my favorite, and I think it's one of the best done of all of the books. This one does have an introduction from the American Philatelic Society, and it's quite well done. And this one is a book that is currently out of print, but you shouldn't let that dissuade you from trying to find one, because many used bookstores still have copies of this book. The Stamp Atlas that I have is a 1986 edition. I've seen recently in a used bookstore, I think it was Abe Books. I'll put a link in the description to the video. They had a 1989 edition that was still available, and you can still find these if you look and if you explore them a little bit. But let's take a look at this book a little bit, and again, I'll put up some still photos so you can see what I'm talking about here and how much I like this book. The American Philatelic Society wrote an introduction to this stamp atlas. It does cover even pre-1840 history, before there were adhesive postage stamps, and does talk about various mail routes throughout the world and methods of delivering mail and things like this. It does get into, with some full color maps, various boundary changes and even country names throughout history. It talks about postal routes, various methods of transport. It also has illustrations and a very good discussion of things like postmarks and frankings and currencies. And the book is organized in a continent by continent and then country by country breakdown. So let's take a look at some of the pages of the book, and we'll go through quite a few of these. This is a fascinating book. I really love it. As you can see in these pages, this is one map on the left is pre-1650, and then the one on the right is 1650 to 1793. So this is quite an old atlas depiction of the parts of Europe and the borders of the countries, the countries' names, some of which may have changed over time, this type of thing, who was ruling, or you know, what nation might have had control over multiple countries, this type of thing. And the discussion, the text that goes along with these maps does get into things like how mail was carried, you know, between countries before there were, you know, real post offices, and the idea of postage stamps and that type of thing. So the stamps in this book are a wide variety. They cover many different countries, and we'll see a few examples of those coming up. But I really love these maps. I love the color. The printing is excellent, I think. There's no real tiny fine print that you can't really see without a magnifying glass, especially if you're getting a little bit older like myself. So the maps themselves that are scattered throughout the book are just excellent. I think they're well worth the book. Now, here's another example of another page. This is from a little bit later in history. This is 1815 to 1850. And you can see here that some of the countries have dates in a little black box with white lettering over the country, and that's the date of when these borders were finalized for that period of time for that country. So they could have changed after this, or they could be changing in the future. There is a very good key in the top of the page, usually a color-coded key, that tells you what countries were part of the Ottoman Empire, for example, or part of Prussia. Again, an excellent example of the geographical layout of various countries that can be very helpful if you found a stamp that was from very, very old, one of the first stamps that was ever printed or ever used. And you can see here what the countries, what their borders were like, and if you weren't even familiar with exactly where the country was located, you can find that as well here. Here's another type of map that is included in the Stamp Atlas, and these are postal routes. Now, these postal route maps are for various countries in here. Again, they have a nice key in the upper right-hand corner this time, and also a little mileage guide so you can kind of judge distances as well. And then they do have text that talks about all of these routes, and it indicates things like, oh, this was the start of a mail packet, where mail would then go from the end of this route by sea to another country. For example, the bottom left-hand corner, it says mail packet to America, and that's where mail was shipped from Britain to America by sea. And so these postal route maps, again, I think are very interesting and very helpful for the collector who might be interested in the history of how mail actually moved and was transported around various countries of the world. The book also has some illustrations that are of interest to any type of collector here. For example, there's a painting on the left here. This was from 1819. It's depicting a London postman collecting the mail from a woman that wants to mail a letter, and notice that she's giving him probably a penny in those days because the sender of the mail had to actually pay for the delivery at some point in time. That changed later on when we started to get into the pre-postage stamp era. Often the recipient of the mail would have to pay for the postage for receiving the mail. So that history kind of has changed a little bit throughout, and the Atlas gets into a little bit of that. The painting on the upper right-hand side is a Scottish Highlands painting from 1848, showing a man in a kilt delivering the mail. And then on the bottom, there's a little table. These are British numeral postmarks that were used abroad. So this book is excellent for that type of information as well, if you're looking for various postmarks, dates, you know, the whole history of that type of thing, of how mail was organized as it was transmitted throughout the world. A lot of information in this book of all different types. Here's some examples of stamps, and again, they're just showing in this case from various countries like Norway and Sweden, how the stamps depicted rulers of the countries and what year the stamps were made. So there are stamps shown in here as well to kind of tie in the postage to the country and how things changed as the countries themselves may have changed. Here are some postmarks from Australia, from Queensland. So this book also gets into postmarks, which can be very helpful if you're trying to identify covers, or if your collecting interests lie in identifying postmarks and having a variety of different ones in your collection. And this is an excellent resource for that reason as well. Here's another map that's a little bit not the full color, you know, various all of Europe type of map. There is one that was for this part of the world included in the book, but this is kind of a little snippet that showed a specific type of delivery. This was for French and German mail boats from 1886 to 1914, going between Australia and Japan and China. And this was a fascinating little map too. I like these little maps in here that you can actually see how the post managed to make its way between different countries that were at one point in history predominantly controlled by European countries. It also has some engravings in here which are fascinating for the collector. This one is called The Post of the Desert. It's an engraving by Horace Vernet from 1876 depicting a person who was delivering mail by camel. So this type of thing also I think I love. This is just great stuff. It shows a little bit of history and shows the differences of how mail had to be transported and delivered throughout the world. Okay, so this type of stuff is included in the Stamp Atlas. It's a lot of information in here. It's a fairly big book, which is nice because then many of the maps are easy to read. The text is easy to read. Again, it goes by continent first, and then it breaks things down country by country within each continent. So again, it's an out-of-print book, but you can find used copies. I highly recommend you look into it and see if you can find one and if you really like it. If you have different atlases that you like as well, please leave a comment and some information on that. And maybe in a future video, we'll take a look at some of your selections for a stamp atlas and we'll compare some notes on that type of thing. So let's move on to the next book in the video today. The next book is one of the basic textbooks for the hobby. It's kind of a standard that's been out there for a long time. Again, it's out of print, so you're going to have to search for a used copy, but this is really almost the Philatelic Bible for collectors out there. And this is the Fundamentals of Philately. And again, just like the previous book, the Atlas, I'll put up some still photos that we can take a look at parts of this book. Fascinating book. Love it. It's a very heavy textbook, in not in weight, but in content. There's a lot of information in here, and it's not something you're going to sit down and read from cover to cover, in a couple of weeks or something like that. Most people I know that have this book would look in and dip into it in different sections. They might look into a section on embossing or look into a section that was on the different printing methods. Or they might look at, perfins or something like that. Line engraving, different things like that. All of these topics are covered in a great deal in here. Even things like the gum on the back of a stamp or the types of ink used on various stamps. So, excellent book. Again, might be a little bit harder to find a reasonably priced copy, but I encourage you to look around and see if you can find one of these. This is the table of contents from the Fundamentals of Philately. And again, it has an introduction from the American Philatelic Society, and then it gets into, starting from the very beginning, just what is collecting and what is philately. It talks about the aims of collecting, and then it gets into paper and watermarks, the stamp design, how a stamp moves from design to an issued final sheet, various printing problems and varieties of printing methods that were used for stamps, the printing characteristics, things like line engraving and other methods of printing, gets into embossing, relief printing, all the different inks and color and how they were used in stamps and throughout history, gets into the gum, which can be a quite in-depth topic. When I first read some of those pages on gum on stamps and the related terms. it was quite complex. I was kind of surprised by that. There's an awful lot of material and information there. And then separation, you know, like perforations and things like this. The book is great. Again, it's a very large book. It does have a lot of photos in it, though, as well, to kind of help you through here. Here's one just showing a little bit in the chapter. It was talking about different types of paper that have been used in stamp manufacture throughout the world and throughout history. Here's another one that talks about watermarks and different types of watermarks throughout the world. This was a section that I really loved. This was a lot of fascinating information on watermarks throughout the world. Here's some examples where they show photographs of equipment that was used in the printing process. And this was part of the chapter that was talking about line engraving. Here's a perforation machine, and I love these cutout kind of drawings that are almost like an original draftsman drawing of the machine that was included in the manufacture of stamps. Okay, so the fundamentals of philately. A lot of people know that this book exists. I know I've talked to quite a few serious collectors who have copies of this book. And they've used it, and they often have reason to dive back into this book every once in a while. They might find something in their collection that they need a little bit of information on, and this book has a ton of that type of thing in here. It also has an excellent index and an excellent glossary of terms. So if you're a newer collector and you want to find out what somebody means about an unofficial perforation or something like that, or a treadle perforator machine, you can find that information in here. It's some of those more obscure terms in the hobby that we don't really know off the top of our heads. But having a good reference book, this can really give the collector a strong foundation in the hobby to know the background and the technical aspects of stamp collecting. Highly recommended. Again, you can find used copies throughout at many of the more reputable online used bookstores. I know that I just searched today a little bit in my preparation for making this video, and this volume can get a little bit expensive, so it might behoove you to spend a little time searching various bookstores and comparing prices and comparing conditions. But well worth it. Highly recommended. I think it's almost an essential book that should be on every collector's shelves. Since this channel is primarily about topical stamp collecting, the last book in this video is one of my favorites. It's a new book. You can get it through the American Topical Association. And this is Topical Adventures, A Guide to Topical and Thematic Stamp Collecting. Edited by a few people involved with the ATA. Excellent, excellent book. I mean, I love this book. It was copyright here in 2020, so it's a fairly recent book. The color photos in here are excellent. The text is excellent. It's one of my favorite books here on topical stamp collecting. Highly recommended. Another one that I think, if you're a topical collector, is almost a must-have for your shelf. This photo is the back of the Topical Adventures book, and it tells you a little bit about it, that the book explores the spectrum of topical and thematic collecting and exhibiting. It's a convenient reference, and it is. I found it very useful when looking at things about storing and displaying and even getting into exhibits. And so this is one of these books that has a ton of information. It's not a real thick book, but it is large, which is nice, because then when you're looking at the pictures of stamps and the other graphics in here, they're not little tiny photos or anything like that. It makes the book a very beautiful book and just a pleasure to read. Here's one of the pages where they're showing just a few different types of stamps and talking about some of the varieties that could be collected as part of a topical collection. Here's a postcard. It gets into postcards too a little bit, and This is a fascinating one. I just love this image of this particular card. Incredible artwork on here. Well worth seeing. Examples of this kind of stuff can give you ideas on things that you might want to collect or search out and add to your collection. Again, here's some more examples. Topical collectors are often quite used to seeing stamps that are in different shapes, like the butterfly up on the top, and the other stamps that are from Pitcairn Islands. Insects are one of the topical collections that I pursue and love to collect. And it shows in this book examples of different subjects that you might want to collect. Here's another one showing some butterflies that are on a page that was created specifically for this collection. Many topic collectors like to create their own pages for their binders, for their stamps. And this kind of idea is great and gives you ideas in the book on how you might want to display your stamps. There's a lot of ideas on what to collect. There's ideas on exhibiting. There's also how to work with dealers, how to purchase topical stamps in here. Gets into revenue stamps, gets into cancellations, postmarks, picture postcards. How to also add some novelty items to a collection and make some more unusual bits of interest to a topical collection. And I love that kind of thing. That's right up my alley. I like doing that type of thing as well. How to store your collection, some tools that are very helpful for any stamp collector, that type of thing. Excellent, excellent information in a small book. Here's another one that talks a little bit about an exhibit, a thematic exhibit. The information on exhibiting in here and displaying your topical collections is superb. I love it. It was sometimes hard to find all this information in one place, and this book really does a good job of that. So, three books here that you can find. A Stamp Atlas, again, it may be out of print, but you can still get it through various used bookstores. Highly recommend that book just for the maps themselves, maps of the countries and how the borders changed and mail routes, etc. The Fundamentals of Philately, I think that's the golden textbook of the hobby. Ton of information in there, very technical, can cover just about everything you can imagine that has to do with stamps and stamp production. And finally, of course, the Topical Adventures book from the American Topical Association. And by the way, if you're not currently a member of the ATA, I strongly encourage all topical collectors to join. And even if you're not mainly a topical collector, the ATA has a ton of great information and well worth supporting that organization by joining them. So three books here, mainly reference books, essentials for your bookshelf. In future videos, I'll also be exploring some other books that are on my bookshelf that are more about stamps themselves. For example, there might be a book about a specific individual stamp, or about a group of countries, or like there's a book about dead countries and collecting stamps from dead countries. And some also books about just postal history, histories of the post office and things like that. So those books will be covered in the future in other videos. If you have any favorite books related to the hobby, please describe them and give us the title in the description of this video. And let us know, and maybe we'll take a look at some of those in the future. So great information in these books. Find them if you can. Add them to your bookshelf. If you like this video, please give it a like and subscribe to the channel. I'm happy to have you here. I'm glad you're watching the video. And take care, and happy collecting.